The snake quickly turned on Carl and bit him in the fleshy part of his left thumb, just before the first joint. Although Wurmslings are rear-fanged and this one was small, it was able to open its mouth widely enough to sink one of its fangs a full 3 millimeters into Carl's thumb. Besides the fang that punctured Carl's thumb, only one other tooth seemed to have punctured his skin. When the snake finally released, Carl began bleeding from both punctures and immediately began sucking on the wound. This is where I would like to interject that this was a horrible idea and is really a sign of the times that one of the world's most prominent herpetologists would attempt to suck the venom out of a snake bite. For anyone watching this who may one day experience a venomous snake bite, do not try to suck out the venom. This is just as silly as if you, I don't know, went and got a flu shot and then tried sucking your flu shot out. Once something has been injected into your tissues, there is no way to suck it back out, and you are introducing a much higher risk for a secondary infection by putting your filthy mouth on a fresh wound. Nothing against you, mouths are just filthy in general. As we will soon hear, this attempt at sucking out